The COVID-19 outbreak in the city's southwest is intensifying. We have just learnt there are 9 cases of coronavirus linked to the outbreak at the Crossroads Hotel. A staff member has tested positive, and more than 1,000 customers of the Casula venue have been ordered to immediately self-isolate.
It's going from bad to potentially disastrous. Drive-through COVID testing at the Crossroads Hotel has an added urgency. After an 18-year-old worker tested positive. He's a friend of Sandra Sullivan and her family.
He was told last night at about 7, and my son had been with him, so, yeah, that's why we're all here this morning.
Now another close friend of the 18-year-old, a woman from southwestern Sydney in her 50s, has also tested positive. In addition, a woman in her 40s who had dinner at Crossroads on July 3 is COVID positive, and a Victorian man in his 20s who also ate at the hotel on July 3 now has the virus. That's 9 cases so far linked to the hotel. They still don't know the source. Testing will have to go into overdrive.
We're concerned because I've got an elderly dad, so yeah, we need to do the right thing.
600 customers were here on July the 3rd when the 18-year-old was working here. He was still here in the week that followed, with more than 1,000 people walk through the front door. Every one of them will have to be tested and then isolate for 14 days.
We were here Friday night. So unfortunately, yeah, we're queued up because it was a week ago now, no symptoms, so hopefully come back negative.
But even if he tests negative, he must isolate for a fortnight.
A negative test does not mean that you can breach self-isolation.
The gold medal breach went to the 100 or so partygoers who turned up to this Bondi home last night. The house, but thought it was a nightclub. The maximum number allowed is only 20.
I get extremely concerned and upset when we see people flouting the rules that are in place, because that will take us down the path of Victoria.
There were so many it spilled outside. Some had actually turned up in face masks, and there was no stopping them. The after party was at another location in Bondi. The Premier is now threatening a crackdown on large gatherings.
It is absolutely unacceptable for people to be breaching the rules at this stage. We are literally at a crossroads. The next month is absolutely critical.
These overseas travellers flying into Sydney today can count themselves as lucky. From midnight next Saturday, those returning will have to pay $3,000 to cover the cost of 2 weeks in hotel quarantine.
But it's a lot. That's a lot. I wouldn't have people paying that price.
The Premier says the price is reasonable, given that it doesn't cover the cost of police and health checks. Matthew Watson's wife flew in today, only to check into a city hotel for a fortnight.
I can see that there probably should be some contribution in some ways.
On our southern border, 270 cars have been turned around back into Victoria since the shutdown on Wednesday. Mark Burrows, Nine News.
Nine News reporter Alice Monfries is at Casula for us this evening. Alice, a second venue has now closed its doors amid the outbreak.
Well, that's right, Peter. I'm here at Planet Fitness Gym, which is just a few hundred metres from the Crossroads Hotel. And management have just put a sign up on the door here confirming that one of its members has tested positive to COVID-19. Now, the gym is shut, undergoing very thorough cleaning. In fact, just a short time ago, we saw professional cleaners here decked out in hazmat suits spraying down the entrance, not only here to the gym, but also to many of the other shops here in this shopping complex. Now, anyone who went to this gym on Thursday or Friday is urged to get a COVID test immediately. And while at this stage it's not clear whether this case is linked to the hotel outbreak, Queensland Health have released a statement urging any Queenslanders who may have been to that pub to also self-isolate immediately, Peter.
Alice, thank you.